Hello, and welcome back to Game Domain. Today we're bringing you guys an all-new edition of our Uncovered series. As our first video on the infamous Lavender Town Syndrome was pretty well received among the Game Domain community, so be sure to check that video out after you watch this one. For the second edition, we're heading back to the world of Pokemon, and for good reason. This series is going to have a decent amount of Pokemon episodes due to the odd, mysterious nature behind the Pokemon games. Arguably Nintendo's most child-friendly franchise, Pokemon has hundreds of very creepy underlying quirks that lead to great speculation among the community as a whole. Lavender Town Syndrome is, of course, the most infamous example of this, but it is certainly not the only mysteriously creepy inclusion in the original Generation 1 titles, Pokemon Red and Pokemon Blue, or Red and Green if you're in Japan. Throughout the main storyline, culminating in your encounter with Champion Blue at the Indigo Plateau, your rival looks down upon you. But in order to advance the plot, you beat him in every single encounter. After every encounter, Blue's team evolves, pun intended, into a much more formidable and stronger matchup than when you first battled in Professor Oak's laboratory. From your first encounter to your last, Blue adds 5 new Pokemon to team up with his fully evolved starter, which is of course dependent on which starter you choose to help you on your adventure. But throughout this experience of rival battles, there is one odd occurrence that happens between 2 of your encounters with Blue. When you fight Blue on the SS Anne, his party consists of 4 Pokemon: a level 19 Pidgeotto, a level 20 Middle Evolution Starter, a level 18 Kadabra, and finally, a level 16 Raticate, which is the evolved form of his level 15 Rattata that he had in your previous encounter at the Nugget Bridge. Upon defeating Blue, he gives you his usual "smell you later," and presumably heads off to a Pokemon Center. But did he make it in time? The next time you fight Blue is inside of the Pokemon Tower, where you find him staring off at some of the Pokemon graves, almost as if he's mourning something. Upon you talking to him, he exclaims, "Hey, your name, what brings you here? Your Pokemon don't look dead. I can at least make them faint. Let's go, pal." You then enter the ensuing battle with your rival, but are pretty uneased by that conversation. Blue seems off, in a way. He's talking about making your Pokemon faint, which seems like a search for revenge in a way. His team in this battle consists of 5 Pokemon, with an odd switch. The Raticate he had on the SS Anne is gone. He still has his Pidgeotto, Kadabra, starter, and adds 2 new Pokemon that depend on what starter you choose. What happened to his Raticate? This has become yet another hotly debated Pokemon theory, and one of the series' most popular creepypastas, and it has some leverage to it. Although the series is made for kids, we all know the various underlying creepy aspects that the game has to offer. The Pokemon Tower is a graveyard for Pokemon, and Blue is here really for no reason. He wants to catch a Marowak, and even mocks the idea of Cubone's dead mother being the ghost haunting the staircase to the summit. You have a reason to be here, to save Mr. Fuji from the clutches of Team Rocket. But why really is Blue here? Perhaps to mourn the loss of his Pokemon? Raticate is no longer in his party, and it is very plausible that Blue's Raticate was not able to recover from your battle and unfortunately perished. Now, the idea of death in the Pokemon games is really not something that is outlandish as people make it out to be. Death of Pokemon and characters has been very prevalent throughout the history of the games and the anime. This idea dates all the way back to the original games, with the whole idea of Cubone's mask being the mask of its dead mother. This idea of death is even as recent as the story arc of Ash's Litten in the Sun and Moon anime series. Ash's Litten befriended a sickly Stoutland, who eventually died a few episodes later. Litten then befriended Ash, and became a formidable member of his team for the rest of the series. But these two examples show that the idea of death in Pokemon has always been around, and it's really not outlandish to believe the Blue's Raticate theory. But hey, the whole point of this series is to look at things that will always be a mystery. Just random gaming creepypastas that we can delve into and discuss. So, the theory of Blue's Raticate passing away at the hands of your team has now been uncovered. Thanks for tuning in to today's edition of Uncovered. We hope you enjoyed the video, and we'd love to hear some other creepypastas you'd like us to uncover. Tell us what you thought of today's video down in the comments section below. Don't forget to click subscribe and leave a like on today's video, as well as check out some of our other recent uploads. Make sure you also check out the links in the description, as there you'll find the link to our Patreon and to join our Discord. Join our Discord to connect with our staff here at the channel, as well as participate in the great Domain Legion content we have going on there. Our Discord is open to all gaming fans, as we now have over 400 plus fans of the channel and gamers talking about what we love to do every single day. So come on and join to participate in this great community. We would once again like to thank you guys for all of your incredible support, and thanks for watching today's video. We'll see you next time.